Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Tremont. Hallelujah. Meet the Mendeleys of Tremont. That's their name. They have formed a group. Praise the Lord. Initiated by them. Amen. Amen. They want to be in a place where they can give God praise every day.
Yes, Lord.
you are mine. I have called you by name. You are mine. And then the New Testament says that when Jesus was baptized, the heavens opened up and a voice said, you are my son, the beloved. With you I am well pleased. Again we hear, you are mine. In confirmation class, we learned the catechism. And for you who are not familiar with it, the catechism begins like this, this particular catechism. What is your name? My name is Janet Geneva Fraser. Who gave you this name? My godfather and my godmother, in my baptism, wherein I was made a child of God, and something else and something else. Just had to speak a moment. And a member of the body of Christ, I remember that part. But the point is, in all baptism, we hear, you am I. Just as Jesus did, we hear it again, you am I. And as Christian believers, we walk in that boldness. We claim that we are God's. How many times have we said to people, I know that God has my back? Because we believe that in our baptism, God has claimed us as his own. We heard in the Isaiah text, when you walk through the waters, they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned. It shall not consume you. We walk in that boldness. Because we believe it. Amen? My theme this morning is life as a child of the Most High King. But there are two sides to this life. This boldness in which we walk. This heritage that we claim. The baptism, I'm an inheritor of the kingdom of heaven. And I believe that. Which means there is a responsibility. Since I claim that heritage, I have a responsibility with the way I live life. There's a song that I used to sing as far back as I can remember. Many of you may not know it, but those who are familiar with Sankey hymns, you know the Sankey hymns, would know it. My father is rich in houses and lands. He holdeth the wealth of the world in his hands. The diamonds, the rubies, the silver, the gold, his coffers are full, he has riches untold. But this is the one I want you to hear. I'm a child of the King. A child of the King. Through Jesus, my Savior, I'm a child of the King. That's my proclamation. That's my claim. But you know when you're a child of the King, you have a responsibility in the way you live. Amen. Have you ever observed the royal family?
Yes.
No.
Well, one of the first things I notice is their life is not their own.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Some of you are getting quiet. You never thought about that, right? You claim it to be a child of the King and your life is not your own. You don't go when you want to go and do what you want to do without repercussions, right? So there's a responsibility in the way we live. But there's something else unique about us as children of the Most High King. It's not just that we are children, but we are temples of the Most High King. So it's not just a matter of saying my life is not not my own. But the way I live, the way I talk, the what I eat, what I wear, everything I do should represent the life of a child of the Most High.
Wow. Hey.
Amen.
Amen.
So when we talk of 2016 as the year for help, we're really talking about living life as a child of the Most High King. Meaning, I'm going to do my part. You see, we already know that God is doing God's part, amen? That's why we walk in that boldness. That's why we say things like, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? Because we know that God is doing God's part.
Yes.
But the question is, am we doing our part? Am we being who we say we are? Am we taking care of God's temple? And I don't mean this building. Am we taking care of God's temple? And where are you? That music that you listen to, you hello over there on your cell phones. That music that you listen to and take it into your spirit. Because you may say, well, Pastor, we just listen to it, it doesn't mean anything, but you take it in. Just like there's certain foods you wouldn't eat because it tastes yucky. There's certain music you don't want to listen to, as good as the beat sounds, because it is yucky for your spirit.
Yeah.
The foods we eat, the way we take care of our physical temple, do we exercise? So we talk about that again, stretch and jump and all the others. This year we are going to do better. We are going to watch what we eat. The time we spend in prayer.
Yes.
I don't like when I'm only one or two people on the prayer line. The time we spend in prayer, the time we spend in Bible study, the time we spend. You know, people will say, well, Pastor, I just don't have time. And I said to someone yesterday, people can get upset with me, but I, at the age I'm at right now, and I'm not going to tell you my age, some of you know it, but the age I'm at right now, I've learned a few things in life. And one of the things that I've learned is that people make time for the things that are important to them.
Amen.
People will tell you they don't have time to do something. And then you see them someplace else with time. Really? Because, and they may not want to say it, but that thing was more important to them than they made time for it. We all have 24 hours in the day. And we make time in that 24 hours for the things that are important to us. And someone would say to me, Pastor, yes, prayer is absolutely important to me. Do you pray every day? And I said it before, I'll say it again. Wake up 15 minutes early. Well, that means I have to go to bed earlier. I'm not going to look at that anymore. I'll get off the computer and go to bed. Hallelujah. So you can wake up 15 minutes early. Spend time in Bible study. I said if all time won't work for you, start another time. Get someone else. It doesn't even have to be a Tremont. Get someone else to study with you. This is important. This is you living life as a child of the Most High King. God is doing God's part. How can we sing, the Lord is my light and my salvation, whom shall I fear? God is doing God's part, but if we are not putting on the armor of God, the full armor, Paul says, then how can we sing it? Hallelujah.
Amen.
When we talk about exercise, we're going to bring our blood pressures down. We're going to watch what we eat. Reverend Abby, would you please stand? Brother Phil, would you please stand? Reverend Abby and Brother Lynn are working with us as far as body, mind, and spirit. How do we connect these three and live a healthy life? They have started an initiative here in the Bronx. Because as you know, Bronx has some of the worst statistics when it comes to health. We have statistics that we're in a third world country. And even worse than some third world countries. We can do better. But and we can say it's in the community, it starts with us. I cannot go out and teach someone how to be well unless I'm well myself. We have to be willing to walk the talk. I can't say to you, you need to eat, watch what you eat, when I'm, you know, doing something else. Because remember I said last week, you can fool some of the people some of the times. You may even be able to fool all of the people some of the times, but you can never fool God. And the Spirit knows exactly what you're doing. And the Spirit bears witness with your spirit. So if I'm not living the way I'm talking, my words are fruitless. My words are fruitless. Because the Spirit cannot testify to a lie. We don't like to think like that. We think God just won't be on our pulse and see our needs. Hallelujah, I thank God for that. But when we talk, you have to testify. You have to testify to what you know. You cannot go to court and say, I heard. You have to say, I know it because I experienced it. I saw it with my own two eyes. I felt it. It is what you know to give testimony to. Today is healing Sunday. As we remember our baptism and remember how God has claimed us as God's own. We remember that we walk in that proclamation. We have the audacity to say, God is my Father. We have the audacity to say, Jesus is Lord and King of my life. We have the audacity to say we are filled with the Holy Ghost. Then we have a part. We have a responsibility in the journey. And the first thing is to empty yourselves and open up to the Spirit so God can have God's way with us. And then to watch the way we live, to be diligent in that. As we come to the altar, we will end service here and then we will pick up in Lee Hall. As we come to the altar, we sing the song, let your living waters flow over my soul. Let your Holy Spirit come and take control of every situation that has troubled my mind. All my cares and burdens unto you I bring. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Father, Father, Father. Spirit, 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 Spirit. The altar is